So, your uncle. What's wrong with him?
He's possessed.
As in the devil?
Something like that. He says a dark man is following him, watching him at all times.
What do you make of it?
It's nonsense, of course. But I'd be lying if I said it didn't bother me. You see, it runs in my family.
Possession?
No, Detective. Deteriorating melancholy. Practically every member of the Hartwood family is driven mad before they grow old.
But Jeremy didn't kill himself. Is that why he's at your setup?
Despite being convinced that he is truly possessed, he decided to put his last chips on Dr. Gray and his psychoanalysis, figuring he might stumble upon some cure.
You mentioned a letter.
I received a disturbing letter from Jeremy accusing the staff and all the other patients of being involved in some cult. And now they are also out to get him.
Could it be real? Or is it all just in his head?
It's a story he tells himself, Mr. Carnby. Anything to avoid the truth.
Which is?
That we're all terribly insignificant. That people mean so very little to one another. That there is no one out to get Jeremy Hartwood because he isn't worth getting.
Here we are.
My uncle's not well, Mr. Carnby. I want to make sure he's all right.
Then what's my part in this? You couldn't get a cab?
I just wouldn't feel safe going alone. Did you bring a gun?
Yeah. You think it'll actually come to that?
No. But you might need to wave it around depending on how agreeable the staff will be.
What exactly are we gonna do when we find Jeremy?
I don't know. Let's just find him first. So quiet. Where is everyone?
This is a big place. Maybe they're on the other side of the house.
Stay here. I'll have a look.
Sinful New Orleans. wait. Don't.
Excuse me? Do you know where I can find Jeremy Hartwood?
Well, of course not.
McCarthy, what are you doing? I told you not to lose sight of the girl.
Don't you worry, Mags. I'll find that little rascal.
Who are you people? What are you doing here?
I'm sorry about all this, but I'm looking for my uncle. His name is Jeremy Hartwood.
What are you doing, child? You shouldn't be alone. Go find McCarthy.
Who are you? Are you here for the Fay Dodo?
Go upstairs now.
My name is Emily Hartwood. I'm the niece of Jeremy Hartwood. This is Detective Carnby.
The police? Why are you here?
No, I'm a private investigator. Sorry to bother you. My client's worried about her uncle. He's a patient here at Derceto. If you don't mind, could you direct us where to find him?
No, I can't. Jeremy has gone missing. If you leave your information, I will make sure to contact you.
Wait, he ran away?
No, he won't leave the house. He's around here somewhere, and both of our orderlies are looking for him.
That's unacceptable. Where's Dr. Gray? I want to speak with him immediately.
Fine. I'll ask him. Wait here and don't touch anything.
Do you want to see Jeremy's room?
Can you show us?
Follow me.
Thank you. Strange kid.
Let's look around, see what we can find.
Have you ever seen anything like this? Looks like a talisman.
You mean like this one?
Can you find me a knife to cut the canvas? I want to take this with me.
You want to take the painting? Sure, I'll find one.
Found this tube as well. Should keep it safe for you. Do you want to carry it or should I? Miss Hartwood? Emily?
I'll take it. Thank you.
We're done here, right?
I'm not sure. I don't know how to do any of this.
Listen, I think we should talk to Dr. Gray. He must know something about what's going on around here.
Okay. Let's do that.
Come on, I don't want to be here all night.
Detective Carnby? Where did...
Thank you.
Baptiste?
How'd you get here?
I was back at Derceto, looking for my Uncle Jeremy.
Jeremy's your uncle? I didn't know.
Why would you? You're still working at Derceto?
Yeah, both me and Lotta stuck around. We're real orderlies now. You remember my sister Lotta, don't you?
What happened, Baptiste? How are we here?
You know about the dark man haunting your uncle?
I'm familiar with his mental state.
I think we all in his head somehow, because these streets are real, but they're not like on any map. Nah, this is like when you remember something, but in the wrong way.
Do you know how to get back to Derceto? I'm not safe here.
True words have yet been spoken, Mrs. Marcus.
Don't call me that. It's Miss Emily Hartwood. There's no reason to call me anything else.
I'm sorry, Miss Emily. I'm just trying to tell you like it is. This place ain't safe for no one. There's evil hiding in the dark.
How do I get back?
Only Jeremy knows how. He has this juju necklace guiding him.
You mean this talisman?
Mm-hmm. Just like it. He says it's been protecting him ever since he got it from Miss Jackson down the street.
You know where it came from? Have you been there?
I was there no more than 1 hour ago looking for Jeremy. Locked it up to keep the ghouls from getting inside. You can have the key if you want.
Thank you. I'll take a look.
Stay safe, miss.
Good to see you again, Miss Hartwood. Mrs. Thompson told me you were here. She also alerted me that you brought a detective with you. I'm very curious to hear what this is all about. You don't remember me, do you, Miss Hartwood? We met at your family's house in the Garden District, when your uncle was about to be admitted under my care.
No, I remember. Sorry. I'm not really feeling well.
Oh, in that case, have a seat. Let me make you a drink. I don't seem to have made much of an impression on you. On the other hand, I can vividly recall you and your parents.
Because of our cheerful disposition, I'm sure.
You are far too intelligent to think that. You come from a joyless family, Miss Hartwood. The only amusement I took from my visit was discovering that the young lady's drink was an old-fashioned.
Very astute. Is that supposed to make you seem attentive or intelligent?
Whatever you prefer. Are you ready to tell me why you are here, Miss Hartwood? And why you brought a detective?
I received a letter from my uncle. He seemed certain that he was in danger here. If I find out you're treating him badly, I'll be taking him back with me to New Orleans.
Really? Is he going to live with you in your tiny garçonnière? That would be a spectacular way to ratify your spinsterhood. Because you are well aware that your father would never let him back in his house. No, I have it. Maybe you can bring him back up north. You've been wanting to move back for quite a few years, haven't you? You always preferred your mother's side of the family. Jeremy is free to leave with you. I won't object. However, there is one problem, as you might have learned. He is, in fact, missing.
Do you know where he could have gone?
No, I'm afraid I don't. I have my staff looking for him. I'm sure he will show up eventually. Especially if he learns that you are here. He is quite fond of you.
What can you tell me about his condition? I never heard a proper diagnosis. What is your medical opinion of him?
Well, let me think. He is an anxious man, depressed, even. He suffers from a perceived lack of order in his inner and outer life. He constantly complains about events not presenting themselves according to their divine nature.
In the dark man?
Hard to tell if it was ever anything specific. Jeremy uses the dark man as a psychological scapegoat to avoid facing the truth that he is in any way at fault.
You don't think there can be any truth to the dark man's supernatural existence?
Why would you ask that?
Can we ever be sure?
If the Dark Man is some sort of evil presence that is in possession of Jeremy?
Well...
I assure you, any evidence that you experience supporting that claim is purely delusional. Don't get caught up in mass hysteria, Miss Hartwood. You wouldn't want to take your uncle's place in this hospital, would you?
I'll be leaving now, Doctor. I need to keep looking for my uncle.
Do so, Miss Hartwood. I'll let you know if he shows up.
Detective Carnby! God, I'm glad to see you. I was afraid you had left.
Me? You're the one who just disappeared.
It's hard to explain. I think I blacked out. It was like I went somewhere else.
It's okay, miss. You're clearly upset.
No, it's... I don't know what's happening.
This is a very stressful situation for you, I understand.
Ugh, no, you don't understand.
Just take a deep breath. Why don't you sit down, smoke some of the perique? If you want, I could even drive you back to New Orleans. I just want to have a talk with Dr. Gray first.
I want to stay. I found a talisman just like the one in the painting. I think I might be able to figure out where Tarawea is, where Jeremy wanted to go.
That's great. Just stay out of trouble, okay? Let me handle the investigation.
I'm not crazy, Detective. Not yet.
Okay, catch you later.
Good evening, Miss Hartwood. That is your name, isn't it? I would be terribly embarrassed if it wasn't.
You're right. Emily Hartwood, Jeremy's niece. Nice to meet you.
Ruth. Ruth Talon. Perique you're smoking? How terribly quaint.
Maybe so, but I like it.
Would you care to share some? That smell is making me feel very nostalgic.
Is it all that you hope for?
I enjoy your light mockery, Miss Hartwood. I can tell we would make great friends.
How flattering. Too bad you're locked up in this place.
Your insincerity is really refreshing. I wish you were mad as I am. Then you could stay.
Give it a few years and I might just be. Lunacy is one of my family's few privileges.
Oh, good. I'll be looking forward to it.
You don't know anything about what happened to Jeremy, do you?
Everyone here is really strange, and it's hard to know what to make of anything you hear. Occasionally, it sounds quite exciting, though. Good versus evil and all that. I'm sorry, but I don't think I have anything useful to share.
It doesn't matter. Thank you for the much-needed break.
Bon voyage.
wesaki nan petwen nun promisaki nan petwen men le anjeni man man yo deshena.
What are you doing sneaking around? You almost scared me to death.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to disturb your ritual. I wouldn't have guessed voodoo was in practice at a place like this.
The doctor may be all about science, but I know these roots have power.
You know what's going on here? I have a feeling Derceto is cursed.
There are several players with stakes in this game. Derceto isn't cursed or blessed. It's a battleground. And it would all be a lot better if you could get your uncle out sooner than later.
That's all I'm trying to do.
I wish you the best of luck, Miss Hartwood. I really mean that. Now, if you'll excuse me, I need to look after my gombo.
Jeremy, you dropped your...
Mrs. Marcus?
Get off of me!
What are you doing here?
Trying to find my uncle.
Jeremy is your uncle?
Could you please? Thank you. And it's Miss Hartwood.
You don't remember me?
I remember you, Mr. Bois. I met your brother, Baptiste, earlier.
I suppose he hadn't found Jeremy either then. We spread out to find him.
Can I have this? I'm trying to get to Tarawea.
Fine, believe the rest. I just want Jeremy to come looking. We have to leave before it comes inside.
What? Where?
Come quick.
Oh, God damn my soul.
Come on, Grace. I'm too tired for games. I'll even let you play with my jackknife. Oh, good evening. You haven't seen a little girl by any chance, have you?
I don't think so.
You would have known if you did. The only kid crazy enough to be in this place.
She's not in her room, then?
That would be a first. Always running around causing trouble. She's very hard to pin down, that one. You want a sip?
I'm good, thank you.
Well, I should be going then. Unless there's anything you need from me.
I just want to find my uncle before anything happens to him.
Oh, don't worry, miss. He'll show up. He is much too lily-livered to kill himself.
Why would he?
It's his greatest ambition, didn't you know? Take care now.
Do you teach piano as well?
Huh?
You're a governess. Did you teach those clawing Casino kids how to play the piano?
How do you know about that?
Just because grown-ups don't notice children doesn't mean we don't notice you.
Yes, I taught them some piano.
Are you any good at it?
Not good enough to play a broken one.
It fell from the attic, brought half the ceiling down.
It was Jeremy's fault, wasn't it?
Nobody knows what happened, but you're not wrong.
Emily, is that you?
Jeremy.
What are you doing here?
Well, you sounded so miserable in your letter. I've come to take you away from here.
I can't believe I made such a foolish mistake. All I wanted was for you to stay away.
What do you mean?
I bargained with the Dark Man. A pact to keep New Orleans safe with my own life as tribute.
The Dark Man isn't real, Jeremy. There's nothing he can do to hurt you.
How do you think any of this is happening? How do you still not trust my words?
Fine. Then let me help.
Don't be foolish. He will bury you next to me in his sunken temple for an eternity.
I don't care. I'll find a way. I have my own talisman, and I know about Tarawea.
Oh, wait. Don't speak.
Who's in here? Show yourself.
You know who, Emily. He took your grandfather.
No, I mean it. Who's in here? I can feel someone's in here.
Emily!
Tarawea. Why do you want to go there, Jeremy?
You should not have come, Emily.
How do you know my name? Have we met?
In a manner of speaking. As a manifestation of Jeremy's deepest desires, I am to you unfamiliar. Yet I know of you.
Are you Jeremy? Is that what you're saying?
I am only his subconscious thoughts. I cannot speak for his totality.
How come you have a Spanish accent? And what is this place? Is this Tarawea?
This is indeed the fabled convent of Tarawea, where Jeremy goes to find peace during his sessions with Dr. Gray.
It's all fantasy then?
Based on the things he has read and seen.
And that includes you?
Yes. My name is Juan Luis Jorge. Jeremy once read a book of mine. It stuck with him.
Can you help me break the pact with the Dark Man so we can leave Derceto?
Jeremy doesn't want you to. He wants to honor his word to the Dark Man.
Why? What's the point? I don't understand what the pact is for.
The people of Derceto are calling upon evil to enter this world. Your uncle offered his soul to the Dark Man to contain this disaster.
What? No, that doesn't make any sense.
The pact will be fulfilled at dawn. As the sun rises, Jeremy will forever be entombed in his sunken desert temple. As promised, the dark man shall quarantine and starve the evil inside Derceto.
What about all the patients and the staff?
They will not stand the chance.
That's unacceptable. How could Jeremy agree to this?
Desperation, of course. Jeremy did not choose martyrdom lightly.
Well, nothing is lost yet. I'm sure I can find a way to break the pact and save Jeremy, and hopefully the people at Derceto. What even is this evil you're talking about?
I don't know much. I think some nightmarish entity from the bayou.
I'll just have to deal with that later. First, I have to get Jeremy out of his deal. What? Did you run out of arguments?
You're actually quite inspiring, Miss Emily. If we put Jeremy's feelings aside, I would have to say I agree with you.
Really?
You might just be able to save the old man from himself. I think you should take a look in the convent library. Try to find the truth about Jeremy's relationship with the dark man.
Okay.
You should know that you won't be alone in those grand halls. The dark man has been reading those books for years.
He's here?
You'll have to be very careful.
Of course. I can be careful.
Good luck, Miss Emily.
It was in the hot autumn that I went through the night with the restless crowds. He was a kind of itinerant showman who held forth in public halls and aroused widespread fear. The New Orleans address of the event is lost, but I remember distinctly the Prexed Shipping Company pressing their contribution.
Emily!
Found what you were looking for, Emily. I fear there is no going back.
He's in my head, Juan. His breath replacing mine.
You should not have come, Emily.
Isn't my new best friend. Come, join me for some giggle water.
Ah, Ruth?
Oh, Miss Hartwood, don't tell me you've been out swinging without me.
Ruth, what is this place? Where are we?
Have you never been to the Maccabean before? Goodness me. Tell me, Miss Hartwood, have you ever considered going out for an evening?
Are we in New Orleans?
Oh, who can tell anymore? I just went inside the Grand Parlor and suddenly here I am.
The Grand Parlor? Can I get back to Derceto from here?
Are you sure you want to? We could stay here and drink the night away. How about a gin fizz?
If this is New Orleans, maybe I should go further. Find that magic show the book was talking about. But there was no address, just Prague's Shipping Company.
Oh, is this about where Jeremy met the dark man?
How do you know about that?
Jeremy talked a lot about the dark man. I always felt a bit envious.
How so?
If an all-powerful entity showed me any interest, I'd at least hear him out. I'm sure he has plenty to offer.
I don't think you'd want that, Ruth. You're too sweet for such darkness.
Oh, please. What kind of blue nose do you take me for? I relish the darkness. I think it suits me.
You don't happen to know how to find the Prague Shipping Company, do you?
Of course. Their office is just over there.
Whoa, what happened?
You just got lucky. A bientôt, Mademoiselle Emily.
Hey, do you know where my uncle is?
No, but I bet you're close.
You shouldn't have come.
Don't say that. You needed my help.
All I wanted was to keep people away from Decedo. Especially you, Emily. You're the only one in the family who forgave me for choosing old age over death.
Father still cares for you. He is paying for your treatment at Derceto.
To get rid of me! That's the only reason anyone's at Derceto. Someone in the family thought you were becoming an embarrassment.
Help me get you out of this mess, Jeremy. I want to take you away.
Your father would send me right back.
What if I take you up north, to Kingsport? I know Mother still has family up there. I've been thinking about going for a while now.
I haven't been to Massachusetts in years. I still paint from memory, you know? That old lighthouse makes for a great motif. Your father and I would go almost every summer. Then when our great-uncle died, we stopped going back.
What is there to be done about the Dark Man? He's the one holding you back, right? You feel like you can't leave without paying your debt to him.
The Dark Man has been with me since I was 12 years old. He was standing right on that stage right over there. For a brief moment, his gaze held mine. That was it. I recognized him for what he was. The Hartwood Geist embodied in flesh. I thought it was my turn. But I was only there to be mocked. Instead, his attention moved on to my father sitting next to me. I turned to him and saw his face. The whitest shade of pale I've ever seen. He bit off his tongue that night and suffocated.
What can be done, Jeremy? Please.
There's a way. Two ways, to be exact. One worse than the other. A written contract, now buried inside his sunken temple.
Don't you remember what it said?
I don't want to.
Try, Jeremy. What did the contract say?
No, we can't. We can't let New Orleans suffer that blight. I have to make this sacrifice.
What are you talking about? Is this the thing from the bayou? Juan said something. Psychological trauma. Break through the barriers of self-deceit, temper, manic behavior. Is this it? Is this the contract? Huh? Jeremy. How much pain and suffering you could have prevented.
Emily? What are you doing?
Detective, how is your investigation going?
Well, I still have no clue where Jeremy is, but I think I know why he's hiding. This place is full of lunatics planning to perform some kind of ritual tonight.
Well, that sounds ridiculous. Or rather would have just a day ago.
It gets worse. I have reason to believe they killed anyone who didn't want to go along with the plan.
Detective, have you encountered any monsters tonight?
I just told you, I think they killed people. Beauregard, the author, Perosi, the singer, Mr. Waits, the clerk, Mr. Chance, the gardener, they're all missing.
No, I mean, have you fired your gun tonight?
Of course not. They wouldn't just kill outsiders like that. It would bring too much attention. But you should keep your eyes open.
So you haven't seen anything strange? Been anywhere else?
What are you trying to tell me, Emily? Are you in some kind of danger? Let me drive you back to New Orleans. I think I have enough. You know, at least get the police to take a look at this case.
No, I'm fine. Thank you, Detective.
I'll find your uncle, Miss Hartwood. Just stay out of trouble.
If we can just get rid of Jeremy, everything will go back to normal.
That reminds me. I saw Miss Emily earlier. You remember her? You know she's Jeremy's niece.
She's looking for him.
That's right. She's helping us in her own way.
As long as she don't stand in the way of the mother of a thousand young.
I don't think she knows or cares about that. She just helped Jeremy. I've been more worried about that Detective Carmen fella. He been snooping around asking all kinds of questions.
God, it hurts.
I wish you would stop doing that. Gives me the heebie-jeebies.
Hey, little lady, how's your evening been going?
Ups and downs, I suppose.
I hear that. We all live in the life of an elevator operator.
Are you all right, sweetie?
Do you want to see my mask, miss? I'm making it for St. John's.
How did you... Is that supposed to be my... Ow!
You should learn your place, little girl.
Why are you acting this way? What did I ever do to you? Grace! Grace!
They're coming. I have freed hellish forces, and now the price must be paid. Decadence is the prey of evil. The sun has set. They will find my body, but will not have my soul. I can imagine the master's fury and the terror in the hearts of his slaves. I hear their footsteps. Some may understand what I have done. May God forgive me. Farewell. What would happen if I refuse? Would the whole world come upon? Or would everything conspire to make a new story? Maybe one where I live. Sorry, Frederick.
No one can move. ready to tell me what happened with her?
What's happening?
I put a rope around my neck, and then I strangled all life from my body.
Uncle!
Are you under the impression that you died? Yes. No. I was supposed to die.
What does that mean to you? That you were supposed to die?
I'm the catalyst. I had to die to make the story happen.
Story? What are you referring to, Jeremy?
30 years ago, Frederic needed me to die.
Jeremy!
You're not making any sense, Jeremy. Come back. Find your focus.
Uncle?
I cheated everyone. I didn't play my part. I escaped my doom. Destiny.
Again, find your focus.
Jeremy!
Oh, everything is wrong. Nothing is in place.
Hey, listen to me. We're gonna drown.
Calm down, Miss Hartwood. You're not in any danger.
But Jeremy, he was here, wasn't he?
Miss Hartwood, I am beginning to suspect your family curse is catching up with you. Have you ever talked to a doctor about your condition?
No. No, I was just confused. I thought I saw him for a moment. I'm fine. I'll let you be.
Miss, I want you to know I'm here to help if you need me.
Expeditionary forces face considerable John? Losses in France. The brave men fallen on these
John.
Fields will forever be
oh, as John.
Defenders not of just Europe, but the world.
What's the matter, Emily?
President Woodrow Wilson spoke to our
I can't do this.
Warriors, asking them to stand tall.
What's the matter?
I can't take you dying again.
Speak of them proudly, and remember
I'm still hurting.
What's the matter, Emily?
But the war effort in Europe.
Your death was just so
death numbers on the home front were on the rise due to
unfair.
Influenza known as the Spanish flu. The New Orleans City Council decided to open yet another emergency hospital in the old Derceto plantation.
Visiting you because I couldn't stand the indignity of your awful illness. I was ashamed of you. Ashamed of myself. Forgive me. Please, John. Let me go. Are we done here? Is this what you wanted? break the pact. What else can I do? Wait. It did work. That's why you're coming after me. You're in my head now. In that case, I hope you enjoy your stay.
Emily, stop!
Don't worry. We got you.
Almost painted the foyer with your own blood and guts. Good to see you still in one piece. Stick around, will you? It's going to be an exciting night.
Good to see you made it, miss. And all that ruckus, lot to give you a healthy dose of that sleeping juice. Wasn't sure you'd be waking up again. Had a psychological breakdown. Tried to shoot yourself. Sorry for the manhandling, but he just wanted to save you.
You also stabbed Jeremy in the eye.
Is he all right?
He's a little strange, but everything else is back to normal.
Really? I broke the pact?
I don't know what you did, but it worked. Let's see you standing up, miss.
Jeremy, are you okay? I'm so sorry for hurting you. How can you ever forgive me?
Emily! I missed you so. I do hope you'll stay with me for a while.
Uncle, what's wrong? Is it anesthesia? He seems so meek.
I wish that was the case. It turns out that you managed to lobotomize him. It's actually quite impressive considering your technique.
This is permanent?
You sacrificed a piece of his mind to save the whole. It's a little like treating a bad knee by cutting off the leg. It's blunt, but it works.
That's terrible.
Perhaps. But at least he won't suffer anymore. Do you remember the dark man, Jeremy?
Yes. Where did he go? I hope he is doing all right.
You see, with a violent stab, you made any future treatment quite redundant. I assume you will be bringing him with you back to New Orleans.
I will. I just need to find Detective Carnby.
Everyone knows what to do. Y'all know the new words.
Mrs. Thompson, we talked about this. I'm not sure everyone is comfortable.
Doctor, I insist. This is important. We've waited for so long, Doctor.
Let's just go with the old song. Not every change is an improvement.
Boss, good or bad, we need to move forward.
All in, Doc. Let's bet it all.
But we don't know what we're dealing with.
It'll be okay, Doctor. Better even.
Their praises in abundance to the black goat of the woods. Hear us, brother. Take pity on us. Take pity on us.
Ever there,
ever there,
Accept us.
Enjoy our
worship.
Edward!
Get out, Emily! We're leaving!
No!
There has to be a sacrifice!
No!
Emily, are you all right?
I don't understand anything that just happened. What was that?
The whole gang was a cult dedicated to something called the Black Goat of the Woods. I've been trying to gather as much information as I could. It was only after you started talking about monsters that I thought maybe there was some truth to all the nonsense I was finding.
Where's Jeremy? Uncle, are you all right?
Everything is out of order. This isn't the way the story goes. I shouldn't be alive.
Don't say that. You made it out. Be happy, okay?
Hey, kid. You doing all right?
It wasn't what I expected, but you can't always get what you want.
Ready to head back to New Orleans?
Come on, Jeremy. Let's go.
Can I come?
Don't leave her. You have to take her to Hell's Kitchen.
What on earth are you talking about?
Where are you, Emily?
I'm in his temple.
Why?
It's what I see when I close my eyes.
Are you afraid?
No. Not anymore.
Hey, kid. What are you up to?
Nothing much.
Yeah? Anything I'm gonna have to pay for? You're bored, aren't you? Yeah, I can tell. You wanna see if we can tear your mother away from the play?
Can you believe they're still going? It's been hours. You forgot this.
Well, I just didn't want you to think we had abandoned you in there.
Can we go home?
Yes, please, can we?
What, you guys didn't like the play?
It was all right. A little difficult to follow.
Oh, I agree. Let's just say there were moments where it left me alone in the dark.
Oh, God.
That's the name of the play.
Whoa, what do you know?
Did you like it, sweetie?
There should have been a hedge maze.
A hedge maze?
Uh-huh, and pirates. That would have been fun.
Well, maybe next time.